Energy insecurity is an inability to adequately meet household energy needs. Approximately 16 million households in the U.S. Are impacted by energy insecurity. So there are three dimensions to energy insecurity. The first are housing conditions that reflect structural deficiencies in the home, such as drafty windows or other areas that might create holes or leaks that then trigger moisture and dampness in the home. And the other part of it are just kind of inefficient appliances and heating and electrical systems. The second part is related to the economic ratio, so the economic burden associated with utility bills in relation to household income. And the third dimension are the kind of coping strategies that low-income households use to improvise, and they use heating alternatives such as stoves or space heaters, but they might also be extremely vigilant of the thermostat and keep their homes at a kind of a subpar temperature in order to regulate and control on the, you know, on some level the expenditures associated with energy. Energy insecurity, for as prevalent as it is widely ignored. It's beyond the public's consciousness. It is very much overlooked in the scientific literature, and outside of public policy's domain. As the impacts and the extreme weather events related to global climate change increase in frequency, severity, and are less predictable, things like heat waves kind of negatively impact vulnerable households, and the elderly and the poor are much more likely to sweat it out or die. The competing expenses, though, lead to a heat versus eat dilemma, where people have to consider putting food on the table or putting oil in the oil tank. A harmful temperature and humidity conditions in the home can actually lead to excess moisture and mold, and also trigger respiratory illnesses such as asthma. The burden of energy insecurity can actually lead to parental and child stress, anxiety, and depression as they contend with issues around being thermally uncomfortable, but also the kind of financial hardships associated with energy insecurity. It's really interesting because it's a basic need, just like housing, just like food. In fact, I argue that there's a trifecta of insecurity and that they're very much interrelated, so that you have the kinds of housing insecurities and food insecurities that are very much well established in the public health literature, and alongside, you know, having a decent place to live and food on the table, you also need to be able to meet the kind of basic functions of everyday life, right? And so on the one hand, it's turning on a blow dryer, but it's also, you know, having sufficient cooling or sufficient heating, and having the kinds of up-to-date and well-maintained electricity sources. One of the things that I present in this particular paper as a viable alternative, and something that we should honestly consider as an intervention opportunity for housing, health, and energy, are energy efficiency interventions. And energy efficiency interventions can actually run the gamut from, you know, basic caulking around windows to actually replacing boilers and, you know, heat sources. And this would attack the problem of poor housing conditions. It would also address the issues, the economic burden issues associated with energy insecurity, and also start to reduce the triggers that are associated with asthma, but also potentially with stress. So these kinds of issues that have implications for family well-being and household well-being. So as we consider the need to modernize our energy policy, and as we move forward into a new era of health policy with healthcare reform, it's extremely timely to think about energy insecurity and the associated energy efficiency interventions. It's also really important to create an evidence base where we understand this phenomenon and this concept a lot better. To position it as a major public health concern, but also to fuel scalable policy changes in the realms of energy and health.